President Trump is now on day five of insisting Alabama was in the path of Hurricane Dorian.
That was the original chart.
After being ridiculed for displaying a forecast map altered by a black marker to prove his point, Trump tweeted today that Alabama was going to be hit or grazed, and then Hurricane Dorian took a different path. He now says he was referencing early predictions when he claimed Alabama could be impacted.
I know that Alabama was in the original forecast.
But he first made that assertion Sunday, long after the state was ruled out as a potential target. While the Gulf Coast was shown as a possible threat for Dorian's track in early projections, by Friday, the guidance had shifted to Florida's East Coast, 2 days before Trump said this.
This just came up, unfortunately.
The president canceled a trip to Poland to monitor the storm, and the White House said he was being updated every hour, meaning he would have known that information. Instead of admitting the error and moving on, Trump is insisting he's right, even tweeting out projections last night from over a week ago with dated information. The spaghetti models the president is using as a defense are updated 4 times a day, meaning by the time Trump made this claim Sunday,
Alabama could even be in for at least some very strong winds, and something more than that it could be.
They had been updated at least 15 times. It's against the law to knowingly issue or publish a false weather forecast, though right now, both FEMA and NOAA are referring all questions back to the White House, where aides are refusing to say who it was that altered the map and won't rule out that it was the president.
I don't know.
Now, Jake, regardless of who it is that did alter that map, right now it's clear the president does not have any intention of admitting he was wrong about Alabama, because he's still continuing to tweet about it just moments ago. Even as this hurricane is now hitting the Carolinas, the president is still tweeting old maps that showed that there are chances it could potentially affect Alabama. Maps from over a week ago that the president just tweeted out several moments ago. And right now the people we've spoken to said they do not expect the president to stop anytime soon, Jake.
All right, Alabama's own Caitlin Collins, thank you so much. Appreciate it. Amanda Carpenter, because you wrote an entire book about this, about how President Trump gaslights the American people. Look, no one disputes that a week ago there were some projections that showed a possible slight effect on a small sliver of Alabama. The point is that on Sunday, by the time he started warning Alabama, those were outdated and the projections no longer said Alabama was in the zone, as the National Weather Service a few minutes later said so. Why is he doing this?
I think all of this is done in service to his ego. He wants to constantly present himself as this chosen one, once-in-a-lifetime president who can only defeat the most historic threats we've ever faced, right? So if he has the chance to hype the storm as something bigger than it is, of course he will do so, even if he has to take out a Sharpie and extend the map westward.
We don't know for a fact that he did that, although
everybody... definitely wasn't the guy with the Sharpie on his desk. Okay.
But he's done this
in other occasions. He hyped the humanitarian migrant crisis at the border into a national security threat. When he was campaigning for president, there was a protester who got rowdy, and he tried to say that he was maybe perhaps a member of ISIS. This is something that he does so that we can be thankful when these made-up threats are overcome or diminished.
Manny, I know you have...
not just the made-up threats, he also keeps going, I've never come across a Category 5 hurricane before, because each time he has to big up the threat. And look, if you were a writer on House of Cards or even Veep and you came up with Sharpie Gate, you would be fired. This is ridiculous. The president would never do that. But we have this toddler-in-chief who's now into day 5 of tweeting about this stuff. His press people are like, why are you talking about this? Because he keeps tweeting about it. Yep. He could have let it go. By his standards, by Trump's standards, this is a small lie, a small error, a small mess-up. But he can't let it go, as Amanda points out. And there's a serious point here as well, because we can laugh about this, but a president who won't accept the weather or the direction of a hurricane is not going to accept the result of an election that he loses next November. He's not.
And Deputy Press Secretary Hogan Gidley tweeted in part, quote, watching the media go ballistic over a black Sharpie mark on a map would be hilarious if it weren't so sad. The real news that matters here is a deadly hurricane continues up the coast and tens of millions of Americans could be greatly impacted. I agree with the second part of that. The real news is it matters is a deadly hurricane and Americans are in harm's way. Poor Bahamians, a few dozen of them at the very least, have been killed. But we're covering it because the president just did 2 more tweets on it. He won't stop talking about it.
Exactly. But the president, I think, enjoys all of this because this becomes a media story. And if you are a Trump supporter, you believe him on this, and he has done a very good job of discrediting a lot of things. Never mind the fact that he's in the wrong here. But I think the bigger point here is not the fact that likely the president drew Alabama, whoever, or someone in the service of trying to please him,
right,
of which the West Wing is full of people. It is the fact that the president's word, both in this country and around this world, must stand for what is accurate, what is in the moment, is true. Imagine after 9/11, if President Bush would have said something that was factually just not accurate at that point. You have to be able to believe what your government is telling you. His own government said, sir, that isn't right. But he won't let go of it because he likes this back and forth. And we're not talking about a variety of other things, like the fact that there's not a real agenda that's happening for 2020. They haven't, you know, he's not talking about gun control, other things. Mm-hmm. So anyway, he's happy to talk about Alabama.